President Trump is showing you just how rattled he is right now. On the day he purged a top member of his administration and basically threw a 90-minute temper tantrum in the White House news conference, only hours after his party lost control of the House, he fired Jeff Sessions. Except the man famous for saying, "You're fired," for pretend on television, apparently couldn't say it himself. So here's what he does. He orders John Kelly to fire Sessions. He's a chief of staff, something the president has wanted to do ever since Sessions recused himself from the Russia investigation. And now the former attorney general, who was the first senator to support Trump's campaign, reportedly wanted to stay just until the end of the week. But Kelly told him that he had to go, and he had to do it today. So take a look at these pictures now. It's quite the photo op, isn't it? Sessions leaving the Justice Department tonight to applause from his colleagues. Colleagues who are telling CNN that they learned about Sessions' firing from news reports and, of course, a tweet from the president. It's a pattern. Sessions leaving with his replacement looking on. There's his replacement right there. See that guy? We'll talk about him. He's the acting attorney general, the now acting attorney general. His name is Matt Whitaker. He has oversight of the Russia investigation. I want you to pay close attention to this, all right? This is what Matt Whitaker, this is what he told me in July of 2017 when he was a CNN legal commentator. Here it is.
I could see a scenario where Jeff Sessions is replaced with a recess appointment, and that attorney general doesn't fire Bob Mueller, but he just reduces his budget so low that his investigation grinds to almost a halt.
So we know Matt Whitaker here. We had him on the show a number of times around that time. Another guest who was on this show, who was on set with Whitaker on June 19th. There's the photo right there. He posted this on Twitter today. This is from attorney John Q. Barrett about a conversation he says that he had in the green room before their joint appearance. Okay, he says, "Whitaker told me in June of 2017 that he was flying out from Iowa to NYC to be on CNN regularly because he was hoping to be noticed as a Trump defender and through that to get a Trump judicial appointment back in Iowa." So much to talk about with that because he's not the only one who did it. Fake news, but they want to be on this fake news so that the president can notice them. So that really means it's fake. If you want to be on so the president can notice. More proof, though, I say that the president watches me every night. So the man who is now in charge of the Russia investigation offered a blueprint for cutting the legs out from under that investigation nearly a year and a half ago. Seems tailor-made to appeal to this president. And he did it on television, according to John Q. Barrett, apparently deliberately in order to appeal to this president and get a job. He became the chief of staff for Jeff Sessions a couple months later. And now he is the most powerful law enforcement officer in the United States. Look at the power I have, everybody. Can you believe that? Unbelievable. A source close to President Trump telling CNN the idea of Whitaker ending or suppressing the Russia investigation, not an option right now. I don't know why anyone would believe that or how long that will remain the case, but that's what they are telling us. So listen to what the president said during his news conference just today. Here it is.
"I could fire everybody right now, but I don't want to stop it because politically I don't like stopping it. But you're right. I could end it right now. I could say that investigation is over."
Sounds like a threat, doesn't it? So let's talk about that post-midterm news conference like nothing we have seen before. Remember when President Obama admitted that his party had gotten a shellacking? That's the word he used. Remember when George W. Bush said he had gotten a thumping? None of that for President Trump. You just heard him threatening the Mueller investigation. He also threatened reporters as well. So this is an angry exchange with CNN's Jim Acosta, NBC's Peter Alexander, full of down and dirty personal insults simply because reporters are trying to do their jobs, which is to ask the president questions.
"I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Go ahead."
I think that's unfair.
You're a very rude person. The way you treat Sarah Huckabee is horrible. And the way you treat other people are horrible. You shouldn't treat people that way. Go ahead.
Go ahead, Jim. In Jim's defense, I've traveled with him and watched him. He's a diligent reporter who busts his butt.
Well, I'm not a big fan of yours either, so
I understand.
To be honest.
So let me ask you a question if I can. You repeatedly
You aren't the best.
Mr. President, you repeatedly over the course
Okay, just sit down, please.
I couldn't be a White House correspondent. They would have kicked me out a long time ago. And there's more. The president refused to answer a question from April Ryan.
Sit down, please. Sit down. I didn't call you.
April's going to be here later on in the show. I want to hear from her. The president calling a question from PBS, Yamiche Alcindor, who is African-American, falsely claiming her question racist.
On the campaign trail, you called yourself a nationalist. Some people saw that as emboldening white nationalists. Now people are also saying
that That's such a racist question.
There's nothing racist about that question. Nothing at all. The president could have just answered, could have tried to explain his position. Instead, what do? That old tactic, when you can't really explain it, you attack the person who's doing it. He attacked the reporter. But the president did, did not just target reporters today. He also threatened Democrats if they step up their oversight of the White House, which is their job.
But they can play that game, but we can play it better because we have a thing called the United States Senate.
He even threatened candidates from his own party who made the fatal mistake of not wanting Trump to campaign for them.
You had some that decided to, let's stay away. They did very poorly. I'm not sure that I should be happy or sad, but I feel just fine about it. Carlos Cubella, Mike Kaufman. Too bad, Mike. Mia Love gave me no love, and she lost. Too bad. Sorry about that, Mia.
That's the president. The fact is, Mia Love did not lose. Her race is still too close to call. Facts don't seem to matter much to this president. What matters to him is winning, adoration. When he doesn't get both, he lashes out.